Do you think these colored bottles are for just for color sake only, or like that different flavor of any soft drink? If you are thinking like that, then you are absolutely wrong, because these are blood collection tubes, or in medical terms you can say it as vacutainers or the blood vial. There are a variety of tests we are doing for our body. So for this variety of lab test, there are tubes which contain variety of reagents or additives to preserve the blood sample. So in this video lecture, we will study about all the different color blood vials, which includes color of the tube, additives means which reagent is added in tube, and third, what does these additives do, or the mechanism of additives, and finally, the most important thing is that uses. What are the use of these different colored type of blood collection tubes or vials or the vacutainer? So let's start from this plain vial or the red top tube, as you can see in this picture, red top tube. It is used for biochemistry test, which requires serum sample. So you can see the additive. If we will see, the additives include nothing, but in some cases it contains silica particles which act as clot activator. It is used for serum testing such as glucose, cholesterol, triglycerides and HDL, or the high density lipoproteins, potassium, amylase, alkaline phosphatase, BUN, blood urea nitrogen, CK, cholecystokinin and liver enzymes. If we will move to serological test, we can see Rh typing, antibody screening, RPR, rapid plasma reagin and rheumatoid factor. All these tests we should do in the plain vial or in the red top tube. And next we'll move to the yellow or the golden top tube, where it is also otherwise called as serum separating tube, SST. So it contains two agents. First one, silica particles, which activate clotting and cause the blood cells to clump together. And the second is serum separator. It differentiates between blood cells and plasma. If we will see the use of this yellow or the golden top tube, we can see the taste like urea and electrolytes such as sodium, potassium, calcium and iron. Also CRP, called as C-reactive protein. LFT includes liver function test, bilirubin test, AST, ALT, etc. All these tests we can take blood sample in the yellow top tube or the golden top tube. Next we'll move to the third type of tube, purple or the lavender top tube. These bottles are generally used for hematological test, where whole blood is required for analysis. In this case, the additive or the reagent which is added in the bottom of this purple or lavender bottle tube is a EDTA or ethylene diamine tetraacetate. This is an anticoagulant. So what is the role of an anticoagulant? It removes calcium, preventing clotting of blood. So it prevents clotting of blood, as we require the whole blood sample, right? Now we will move to the lab use, in which test we are taking blood sample in the purple top tube. Tests like CBC or the complete blood count, hemoglobin, platelet count, WCC, white cell count, and HbA1c or the glycolated hemoglobin. We can take this purple color tube in for ESR test also. ESR is the erythrocyte sedimentation rate, or for testing malarial parasite, reticulocytes, and for PTA. For this test, you have to take purple top tube, and in the next we will see the gray top tube, which is most widely common because it contains the additives like potassium oxalate and sodium fluoride. Remember gray top color tube, right? So if we will see the mechanism of this additive, this sodium fluoride acts as an anti-glycolytic agent to ensure that no further glucose breakdown occurs within the sample after it is taken. So it acts as an anti-glycolytic agent, right? And the second one, the potassium oxalate, it removes calcium and acts as an anticoagulant. If you will see the use of this gray top tube, then glucose or the sugar estimation, the test includes FBS, fasting blood sugar, or PPBS, postprandial blood sugar, or RBS, random blood sugar, or lactate, and GTT, glucose tolerance test. For all these tests, you have to take this gray colored vials because it contains sodium fluoride and potassium oxalates, which acts as an anti-glycolytic agent, right? And next we will move to the fifth color tube, and that is the light blue. It is used for hematological test, which involves clotting system, as it contains additive as sodium citrate. It contains the additive sodium citrate. What this additive does? It binds and removes calcium to prevent blood from clotting. So we are taking this light blue colored vial which contains sodium citrate. If we will see the use of this blue colored vial, we will see it is used in case of PT. The lab use of this blue colored vial is testing PT or the prothrombin time. It evaluates the extrinsic system of the coagulation cascade and monitors comedic therapy. And the second is APTT or the activated partial prothrombin time. So it evaluates intrinsic system of coagulation cascade and monitors heparin therapy. And the third test is FDP, fibrinogen degradation products. And the next color is dark green. This is less commonly used bottle is for biochemistry test, which require heparinized plasma or whole blood for analysis. It contains the additive as heparin, sodium, lithium or ammonium. It inhibits thrombin formation to prevent clotting. So the use of this dark green top tube is, it is tested as ammonia, carboxyhemoglobin, insulin, renin and aldosterone. And the next color tube is the black. It contains the additive sodium citrate. What this additive does? It forms calcium salts to remove calcium. The use is, it is used in case of pediatric ESR. ESR stands for erythrocyte sedimentation rate. So these are all about blood collection tube or the blood vials color coding. Every people should know this color code, whoever it may be. It may be a doctor, technician, student, staff nurse or a normal people. Everyone should know this color coding because when we are collecting blood samples, it means it is our responsibility that how should we preserve. So if you think this video is helpful for you, then hit the like button and comment me in the comment section that which test is confusing you in the time of collection. To watch my new video next time, subscribe to my channel and share with your friends.